because we had a little bit of a technical issue, so we had to do a retake. So you guys know, it's normal. You know, even CNN and this big, you know, news channel, they have technical issues, so a guy with an iPhone, it's expected. But here we are. We back and we will talk about the Article 7 meeting, talk about term limits.
Yes.
What do you have to say about that?
Listen, we knew all along that we were doing it the right way. And, you know, because the charter provides for a change to take place, has to be either by referendum or by majority vote of the city council. The city council made that vote, and I know that there are some people that disagree with the way we're at. But at the end of the day, you know, it's about election night. No one gets a second term. Term, unless they win the election on election day. So so there are term limits. Term limits are 4. And at the end of those 4 years, you go back to the public and the public will decide if you get reelected or not. All this this did, in my opinion, is take people's restriction away, because under the old law, they were restricted. So if they wanted to keep someone in office, they couldn't. Now they have the option to pick someone new or keep what they have.
So, Mayor, it's going to be a 12-year term if you are re-elected. Let's talk about your vision for Yonkers. When you first became mayor, you found the city in a certain condition. We all remember how Yonkers used to be. We can all look around Yonkers today. We can see the improvement. And we have gone wrong ways. But what is it? What is your vision for you to be happy? Okay, I left Yonkers side.
Yeah. I want to hear less of that. Certainly, that would help. And but you know, that's the whole idea. We're living in a beautiful urban setting, and we live in here in the city of Yonkers. We want a city that has, you know, obviously less crime. We want a city that will be able to educate our children. We want a city that celebrates its diversity, has economic development and activity in it. If our kids can get a good education, we want them to be able to get a good job here and be able to afford housing here. That's what every mayor aspires to. That's what every administration looks towards. And that's a lot of what we've done and been able to accomplish. And we have much more work to do. And that's why I have been pushing for MGM to take the next step. We've become a full gaming facility. When MGM is full gaming facility, we're going to see full-time jobs that are middle-class good jobs, and our kids and our families here in Yonkers are taking advantage of those jobs. And of course, with the building of as many as 22 studios here in the city of Yonkers, starting with Great Point Studios, Media Pro and Lionsgate, and the others that will follow, that will provide thousands of jobs and an education in a new high school that will be about all that, making sure our kids can actually get access to the industry.
So Yonkers is going to be a true Hollywood on Hudson once everything is done. You just touched on the high school. There is 2 new high schools coming to Yonkers. What is the status?
We right now are building a grad school, and that's the Sonia Sotomayor School that will be up and running in the next few months. When I say next few months, within the next year, I should say. That's the first one of 3 new schools we're building. We're going to come forward with another grad school that we're going to build off Ashbury Avenue, and that will be the second one that will be announced. The third one, we believe we'll be rebuilding Gordon. Gordon has to be rebuilt, and so we're looking at rebuilding Gordon. And of course, the newest high school that we're going to have will be the Robert Halley Senior High School that we'll build right in the old Lincoln Watts, where there's a school currently there. We're going to retrofit that school, add a studio to it. It'll be a K-12 school, where kids from the Yonkers, 500 kids, can participate in the magnet program. And at the end of their career at school, from K-6 to 12, they'll have a decision to make. And the decision will be, should I take a job in the industry which would be six-figure jobs.
Well, I don't know how to typeset, I don't know how to work a camera, I don't know how to run the machines and be a carpenter, all the different things that go with that industry. Or maybe go to Syracuse University in Newhouse and take your career even further. And that's what we do for Syracuse, work in the City Department of Education, work in the Yonkers Board of Education, and we are working in U.S. film studios.
Mayor, the folks that are watching this interview are saying that they can hear, you know, the audio is a little low. We might need to speak.
Okay,
yes, a little loud. Now, Mayor, you spoke about housing. Housing is important. We can all go around the Yonkers and see these new buildings coming. But what about, what are you doing for the low-income people? Because lots of folks that live in Yonkers for generations and generations are living in Yonkers. And the main reason why they're living in Yonkers is because they're saying it's getting to be too hard to afford Yonkers.
Well, there's no doubt that affordability is an issue all across the country. Say that the Yonkers is probably the most affordable of any of the communities here in Westchester. We have authorized 12,500 new units of housing. We have authorized in those 12,500 units, nearly 3,000 of those units are affordable. And so we are seeing 22% of all the new housing we're building is affordable. We do that because we want people who live here, who have been here for generations, to be part of the renaissance that's happened. That we rebuilt every single unit of our municipal housing stock. We've done that, we continue to do that. And of course, we're working with nonprofits that are helping us build workforce housing, Wendell Street, South Broadway, Elm Street, just to name a few. Rebuilding the municipal housing stock. And rebuilding in such a way that it mimics what's happening on the waterfront. So all the different amenities that you're getting on the waterfront, all that new housing that's being built, by the way, built on empty property, is being mimicked for the residents that are here. Because we want to make sure that the people who have made Yonkers their home for generations, we want them to stay here. We want them to be a part of the Renaissance. And that's why when we were rebuilding all of our Macy housing, close to 2,000 units, everyone got a voucher that said, go somewhere else. But your first option would be to come back to the Yonkers and partake in the new units when they built.
Now, Mayor, you know that we are live and people are asking questions. A question or two might seem to be out of context, but they take this opportunity, since you are here, to connect and ask you a question or two. There was an incident on Friday the 21st of last month on South Broadway. And this question comes from We United. This is how the question was formatted. As stated by the City Council President, the South Broadway bid is a nonprofit that partners with the City of Yonkers. Why has the city not publicly addressed the incident that occurred between the executive director and the street vendor after the outpour of concern from the Yonkers community? The South Yonkers community is uneasy and feels unsafe with Jessica Gordon being the director of the organization that is supposed to uplift businesses. Will Jessica be terminated from her position to ensure that the community feels safe to return to their business?
You know, I saw that video and I share everyone's concerns on what I saw there. I did a couple of things. One is I immediately contacted the bid, as you know, is a nonprofit, private board. We don't do the hiring part. What we do has something to say, and I've asked them to review this matter and to let me know how they're going to deal with this. Unhappy with the way this individual was treated. I also, which was I think just as important, was to make sure that this individual was given back his spot. So we went there with the city, we repaired the sidewalk that was in question, and made sure that is able to come back, be his spot, and not be harassed by anyone. And so we know that we'll continue to work with them. And as far as Jessica is concerned, I want to at least give the bid the ability to answer me. I don't know, I didn't like what I saw, but is it in context or not? You know, was it a full video or not? These are lots of questions that have to be answered. But no one should be treated the way I saw this individual treated. And that's why we made sure we acted swiftly in getting that sidewalk repaired, getting him back to his spot where he has been servicing this community for over 20 years.
Well, we did interview Jessica. I don't know if you saw that interview. And she accepted that the situation could have been handled differently. So she knows, you know, that the situation could have been done in a different way. This is a question from Dan Murphy. What are your thoughts about the new marijuana dispensary cafe coming to Yonkers, and where should it go? Central Park Avenue?
That's a good question. You know, I supported the legalization of recreational marijuana as a legislator. I supported it as a mayor. I've supported it. I supported it first when I was in the legislature as medical marijuana. My feeling is that there's going to be dispensaries and they're going to be allowed to exist. That I certainly don't want people traveling from Yonkers to go to these dispensaries. They should be here. They should be licensed so that we can monitor. If they're licensed, then they have the ability to monitor them, make sure they're doing things the right way, make sure they're not selling drugs or selling marijuana to kids. Make sure that that things are done, and that they don't have a dispensary too close to a place of worship or next to a liquor store. I mean, these are things that, that they're currently part of the ABC laws that need to be part of this. And so we are waiting for New York State to promulgate better rules, because as a result of New York State's inaction on giving out the licenses, we now have dispensaries popping up all over town. And they're unlicensed. And YPD's been pretty aggressive to go in to enforce the building codes, to close down these facilities. When they open it, they're unlicensed. We had one individual who actually sold drugs to an undercover police officer who was 20 years old. We closed that place down, hoping for that to reopen again. And so, and I complained to the governor about this, and I complained to the state legislature about this. I said, give us rules, give us the policies, give us some licensing so we can enforce it and do it in a way that you do with the ABC, in other words, with alcohol and with cigarettes. And with alcohol and cigarettes, or even if you want to cut someone's hair, you need a license. And if you don't have a license, we have the ability to shut you down. We have the ability to give you tickets. We have the ability to fine you and do the things that we can do that we cannot do under this current law. And that's why we asked New York State to kind of give up their keisters here and get this, move this process a little quicker so we can do what we need to do to protect our community.
So who do we blame, Mayor? Do we blame the people that are operating unlicensed? Or you blame Albany for passing these laws that don't give you the tools or the guidelines? Because if I'm a vendor and I'm going to say, look, if the rules are unclear to you, imagine to me.
Listen, there's clearly the vendors are taking advantage of the fact that their laws don't exist, right? Or that their rules are not where they should be. They're taking advantage of that, right? So that's a problem. But at the end of the day, it's up to us in government to promulgate rules that are there to protect the public. And we have rules to protect people from those who cut someone's hair, sell someone cigarettes, sell someone alcohol. Make sure that they're not sold, like I said here, establishes a faith. Make sure that they're not sold to kids. Make sure that the people are licensed, and so that we know where the product is coming from. Because as you know, some of this product comes from places that could kill you. And we don't want that to happen. We haven't seen that happen just yet, thank God. But what we do know is, the Yonkers Police Department has gone to some of these facilities, has cleared them out of their product, only for them to reopen with a whole new batch of product pretty quick because the price market is massive. And so we, but that's going to continue like that until New York State promulgates the rules. And we have complained, and we've asked New York State to do more. I know other mayors are doing that, and we'll continue to push forward. But it's not going to, the problem won't solve itself, but we certainly aren't going to let people just get away with doing that.
Now, Mayor, there was an article on your post the other day we have to address about the family members of yours working for the city. Some people are very upset, some people are not, some people understand, but from your point of view, how do you react to that, sir?
My whole life, I have been, I've helped dealt with issues regarding the size of my family. Anything from getting invited to a wedding, to a picnic, to a dinner party at someone's home, it was like, oh God, there's so many of these guys. I'm one of 16. I have 119 people in my immediate family. My immediate family. Not talking about second cousins and extended relatives. Actually, I'm talking about cousins. And that 119 is just us in the immediate family with nieces and nephews and great nieces and great nephews. But if you look at my family extended, it's probably 350, 400. Well, I'm going to have another pretty soon. And, my father was a blue collar worker. He was an oil burner mechanic. He worked for a family fuel company. My uncles were all blue collar workers. They were teamsters. And they were, worked with their hands, but worked hard. And I look at my family, whether they're police officers, or firefighters, or teachers, or teamsters, or plumbers, or laborers, they're, like I said, they're just a bunch of blue-collar workers who go out there and work hard. And I know that my plumbers might criticize the size of my family, and it's nice to say that there's too many of them. Just like when we were kids and we couldn't get into the local park because they said there's just too many of them and they couldn't be allowed into the racket club because there were too many of us. This is part of what we deal with. I'm proud of them. I'm proud of what they've done. I'm proud of their hard work. And there's nowhere in any one of these articles anyone talking about anything that where it was done wrong. These are all individuals who work hard. These are all the individuals who call their office home, who are proud of the city. And frankly, I'm not going to apologize for them because of that. And why should I? They're not doing anything wrong. They want to participate in an open and competitive process and get themselves on the list and get picked off that list because they were able to excel in that. Then, you know what? Good for them. But if you look at it statistically, I'm certain that if you look at it statistically, that the number of individuals who work in government is far less in percentage than some of the other people who may be running for public office. But that's not going to be my goal. My goal is not to tear down anybody else. I'm not going to tear down anybody else's family or who they are. I'm just going to build up.
Well, Mayor, last interview that we had with somebody that is running for mayor, she promised that she was not going to get personal, on her campaign. You know probably who we're talking about. I don't know if you saw that interview or not. And did that person benefit from the things that she's now criticizing you?
Listen, I'm not going to get into it. At the end of the day, the people of Yonkers are going to make a decision as to who should be mayor for the next 4 years. And they're going to make a decision based on should I be replaced or not. And they're going to look at my record and they're going to say, is this someone that we want to continue to lead the city? Or do they want to go in a new direction? And that's the decision taxpayers have to make.
I never mentioned Jenny. You said her.
Right. Or be her, it could be him.
Okay. Now, Mayor, what is your goal in regards to crime in Yonkers? Look, I have been in many press conferences. You keep emphasizing that crime is down in Yonkers. But lots of people in Yonkers, especially on the west side of Yonkers, feel that crime is not down.
Okay.
So I always tell people, look, I don't have the statistics, but sometimes we create an impression that crime is high because Paul Ross is always there to film and to show. So years ago, we didn't have somebody on the streets to report everything that happened. So is it realistic to say that crime is down and maybe reporters are up, or is crime up?
No, crime actually is down. If you look at all violent crime, all across the board, in every sector of the city, it's down. And if you look at the areas that we've talked about, and the areas that we've talked about, burglaries and shoplifting, the nonviolent crimes, those crimes are up. That is always, listen, that's always too much for any mayor to want to have to deal with, right? We never, one murder is always one murder too many. And, but statistically, the numbers are down across the board. We're down 40% overall. And like I said, what we're dealing with, what we're seeing nationally, which is shoplifting and car and burglaries and auto thefts. Those are the areas that we are trying to tackle now. And YPD is there. They're on the west side and in the east side. And on Central Avenue and on Getty Square. And what we're doing is we have a special force that we put in place. We are out there getting the message out and tackling the crime as it comes on. But at the end of the day, like I said, Yonkers is still the safest city of any one of the big five cities in New York State and one of the safest cities of its size. Could it be safer? Always.
It's always room for improvement.
And that's what we're going to play to us. But we've been able to do, in the time I've been in office, we've been able to reduce crime to 40%. We've been able to cut arrests in half and at the same time reduce the number of complaints against our officers. And that says a lot about how we police in our neighborhoods, because we're not reducing crime by arresting our way out of it. What we're doing is we're reducing crime by having a hand-in-glove approach, getting our police officers to work hand-in-glove with our community. Doing some of the things that we do, some people might call silly. Stop and shake, pizza with the police, coffee with a cop, the police explorers program. All these things are meant to get our community hiring more minority police officers, because we want our police department to look more and more like the community. That's sooner than ever to protect and serve. All the stuff is having a positive impact on outcomes, and that's what we want to continue doing.
Now, Mayor, do you remember the fiscal condition of the city when you first became mayor? It was not in such a good shape.
No.
And compare it to now. Tell us, how is it?
So we got to office, we had $100 million deficit. We had an operating that was near garbage. The city was facing massive cuts across the board, and what we wanted, and when we had an infrastructure that was in complete disrepair when it came to our schools. So we had to tackle these things one by one. Obviously, we need to make sure that we cleared our fiscal house and made sure we put it in order. And we were able to do that over time. We were able to work our way out of the $100 million deficit, and we were able to build our bond rating. Our bond rating is now A-rated. It's the highest bond rating we've had in 4 years. That represents to the public that the bond makers of Moody's and Standard & Poor's, they see Yonkers as a city that is able to manage its finances and do things it needs to do. We started borrowing money to repair our schools. So we're not just building three new schools, not Dorothy, that what we're doing in the lots, but we're repairing the infrastructure of our schools. For far too long, New York State has not different, we hope, than the communities on our east or west or north and south. But it's something that's coming about, and you know, we start to see graduation rates go with it, so that's good.
Now, Mayor, again, we are live, and people are here pressing into the situation with Jessica. They want you to actually address the issue. People are not happy. And you saying that you saw the video, you're not happy either. But perhaps you want to explain again to those that are just logging in, what is your position?
My position is I want answers. I just inquired, I asked for answers, I'm waiting for them to give me the answers that I would expect that they should give us. In the meantime, I wanted to make sure the vendor was put back in place. One of the problems the vendor had was a problem with the sidewalk. We expedited the sidewalk repair, repaired the sidewalk the very next day. I think we did the next day, and I spoke with the vendor. He was happy. He was able to go back to his spot. That's what I think people should reasonably expect. I think most of the anger was about the vendor. And I know that vendor's been here for 20 years.
No, Mayor, I have
the Jessica's situation will be addressed when they give me something that I can look at.
Yeah. No, people are not upset because of the sidewalk, even though they feel the sidewalk should have been fixed. They are upset at the way that Jessica addressed the vendor. That's what they're upset.
No, but I said that.
Yes,
in the very beginning, that they were upset because I stated about how he was treated. And I thought that was completely insane. And I'm waiting for an answer from the bid on how they're going to handle their employee. But what can I do something about immediately? Well, what I can do something about immediately as your mayor is I can repair the problem, get the individual back, and make sure that no one bothers this individual and that the vendor is protected, as he should be, with somebody who's been here for 23 years. That's what a good mayor would do, and then of course I'll deal with the bid as we will over the next couple of days.
Now, Mayor, you have done a lot of works about the parks in Yonkers. We have, you know, city parks, quality of life, places where children can go and play, safe. Let's talk about that a little bit. Is that more work on the way?
You know, one of the things that we learned very, very quickly in the city, 211,000 people on 18 square, you know, 18 square miles, is that there is not nearly enough park space. There's certainly not enough park space in Southwest Yonkers. And also the parks we have, many of them are complete disrepair. The city council has given me tens of millions of dollars over the last couple of years. We're rebuilding parks. Parks are being rebuilt on the west side. And we're adding park space. We just added Martin Ginsburg Park in Baltimore, Burnham. And we just purchased 3 acres of the Philly Love Street for a new, brand new city park that will get rid of the Otarikum Tank Yard, which is now occupied by some school buses. We're going to be able to get those buses off, get them relocated, and put a new 3-acre park that children in South Yonkers will have access to. I was born and raised in that community. I had no access to the water growing up, but now the kids in that community will. And they'll have access to a beautiful waterfront park that they'll be able to go sit by the water, play ball, have some fun, you know, and we're excited about that. We're able to get Westchester County, George Latimer, and our county legislators agreed to push an additional $15 million. So we purchased the property with $13 million. This county is going to give us an additional $15 million, and we will be in the ground for years end, with any luck, with the brand new park that kids can go home.
Well, may I have two more questions? Yonkers Art Week or weekend is coming up. Okay, you are being an arts, you're being, you know, motivating people to get involved. Let's talk a little bit about art.
You know, we have, what day is that, the 30th, right?
From 4:20 last month until 5:20.
Yeah, so it's the only thing is that it's a day. even though it's hard to weekend, it's hard today. So I'd like it to be more of a weekend, and we're going to work on that for next year, make sure that it's more of a weekend. But we be able to utilize the arts weekend to bring as many as 10,000-15,000 people to the city to go view some of the artwork that we have going on in and about the city. We also have been able to present creators of community awareness about the arts. And the arts is one of the main reasons why the city, I think, economically started to turn around, because we had a lot of promise of the water department. We had really no shells on the ground, no greens in the air. And we didn't have companies like Avalon Bay or Xtel or RXR or Madero or Rhodes. We didn't have those companies. They were deep pocket New York City companies that wouldn't be put in the Yonkers. But once we brought the arts there, once we got Dan Wolf and his wonderful wife to come to Yonkers and to purchase the old city jail, they started to see a turnaround, because the money was following the art. And we have the arts in Yonkers, and the dollars started following it, and the developers started following the dollars. And I think that's one of the main reasons why we see $5 billion in economic development happening in Yonkers.
John Van Nostrand tells me to tell you that he's playing for you and your family.
Thank you. Okay. I know John a long time.
Yep.
And John's been through some tough parts in his life.
Yes, yes.
So I hope you're doing well, John.
Now, Mayor, there was something that caught us by surprise. I was there at your State of the City address. I heard your speech on his entirety. And I remember you praising the school superintendent, Dr. Evan Quesada. Not long after that, he caught us all by surprise that he was retiring, but 3 days later, there was an announcement of a job that he was just going to Pennsylvania. Did this caught you by surprise, sir?
It caught me completely by surprise. Actually, I found out about the Friday before the Monday, he really was not. So the Monday he went public with it, he had told me about it Friday before. And Dr. Quesada, who I consider a very dear friend, was a great superintendent who knew how to communicate not just with the teachers and the faculty or expectations of their work product, but he also had greater expectations for the kids. And he had a wonderful way of communicating with the kids in the district. Kids in the district 61% Latino. Speak English when he got here, but he was able to run himself through the system, get himself educated, become a teacher, become an administrator, school principal, and then superintendent of the Arnold School District in New York State. He was sought after. There were many times that I talked to him, and I don't want to divulge his stuff, but there were many times that he had gotten calls and saying, there were a job offer here, a job offer there. And he got to the point where he could retire. That his wife had recently just retired. And so I think he decided that it was time for him to do something else for a living. And I wish him luck. He's done some wonderful things for us. He's going to be a tough guy to fill his shoes. But we will. And we'll go.
We wish Dr. Quesada the best. Talk about the tough search for somebody to fill his shoes. We had a little survey going on Yonkers Voice, and the support for Mr. Nader Saeed was tremendous. Okay, and many feel that he had been passed on a few times, and the community stands behind him, not just because we like Mr. Saeed, but because he's an educator. He's been involved in the school system forever, and the city of Yonkers feels that he can do an awesome job. Is he on your list, sir?
Well, is he on my list? Listen, I can't.
To interview.
No, there's no doubt about that. Listen, Nader Saeed's on everyone's list. He's certainly on my list, too. And I know Saeed's family my whole life. They're a wonderful family. They're all very young. They're all very well educated. They're popular. trustee Lopez and the trustees, and I know they have, they also have some advice against that going on with some of the PTA members. But just that they got to grow with this. They got to start seeing what's about, what's out there, what's available, and then we're going to have to make a decision. But well, I'll do that pretty soon. But I know that Nair is in the mix, and I don't want to speak for trustees. I'd rather speak for myself.
So now let's speak for yourself. What's next, Nair? You know, I always ask you
this question. After the next 4 years?
Yeah, will be another 4 years? Or, where's this account executive?
I want to serve my term as mayor. I do. That's what I want to do. I know that there are people that talk about running for higher office, for the county executive and all. I know that, like I said, George, I know, is turning that out.
Yes.
I know that the deputy county executive, Ken Jenkins, who's a good friend of mine, is also a very viable option for the county. And, I'm happy to be mayor. I really am. And I want to fulfill my term. That's what I want to do.
But business is business, and we will let the people of Westchester County will be the one deciding who they want. So is that out of the list, or maybe?
I don't. You know, you never say never in our business.
So you have told me no a few times.
You never say never, but it's certainly not something I'm looking for. I have some things I want to finish, and that's why I'm running for running again. And that's my goal, to finish the things I've started. We have Lionsgate, we have 22 studios that are going to get built. We have Yonkers Raceway, and it's not just going full gaming. You know, there's a lot associated with full gaming. It's full game. It's having a community benefits package put in place. It's having the right legislation passed at the state capitol, which I hear State Senator Andrew Stewart Cousins and our delegation are doing a wonderful job in writing or creating that legislation that will allow for a structure to exist that gives Yonkers a maximum amount of money from that track. And so there's lots of good things happening, but there's lots that has to happen, and that's why
Well, Mayor, to conclude this interview, because I'm looking at my watch already past the time that we had allocated for this, what is your words to those guys that are watching and considering the alternative or stay with the Mayor Mike Spano? What do you have to tell them?
I'll tell you this. I love the city. I've been my grandparents, here as immigrants. I'm here with my entire big family. 15 brothers and sisters, all my different cousins, but we're here, and I'm here, because we love Yonkers. We want Yonkers to grow, we want Yonkers to prosper, and Yonkers has a great future, and it's a great future for our kids and your kids, and I want my kids to want to stay here and be a part of all the great things that happen. So with Yonkers' support, I'll be able to continue progress I've made and actually do greater and better things. But at the end of the day, it's up to taxpayers. And you're not going to hear me speak on my opponents, because I haven't had to do that in my time in office. I haven't had to do it. And I'm not going to do it now. And if someone wants to pull off and tear up my family, and you know what? Richard Nixon said it when he had to leave office in shame, right? He said it to his staff. What did he say? He said, "Those who hate you can't win unless you hate them, and then you destroy yourself." And so that's not something that I'm ever involved in. I love the city. I want to build a positive image for our city that includes me as a mayor giving positive messages every single day. And you don't get those positive messages if you tear somebody down.
Thank you, Mayor. That concludes our interview. As always, Yonkers West does not support or endorse any candidate. We welcome any person that is running for office. Our job is to keep you informed so you can make the decision on who deserves your vote to represent your principles. Thank you, sir, and until next time.
Thank you.
Thank you.